Hello there guys, and welcome back to mine and Mal's multiplayer co-op Master of Orion Let's Play series. It's going absolutely really well so far. We've managed to find each other. It's been amazing. What do you reckon, Mal? I reckon we're doing well so far, considering it's only early turns.
We have done exceptionally well, and I wonder if the game, when you're playing this way, I wonder if the game says, hey, let's put the two human players near each other, you know, for potential conflict early on. Which kind of makes sense,
yeah,
because the reality is, I don't know when people play this, how often they play as truly cooperatively, right? You know?
Yeah, I see your point.
But it works out in our favor, because we found each other early, and then once we get, if you go over to research, once we get, where is it at? Right here, Xeno Relations, which would take me 13 turns to get. You want to see how long it would take you to get Xeno Relations?
Actually, won't let me click it at the moment, because I'm on waiting for players, you see. So as soon as you advance your next turn, I will be able to see, you see. It's a bit odd.
Okay, you should be able to do it now.
Yep, so it's just doing it, and now I can. So what are we looking for here, sorry?
What's that?
What are we looking for? Xeno Relations.
Xeno Relations, yeah. Xeno I just picked relations. Up Destroyer and Anti-Missile Rockets. It will take me it'll take me 13 turns to get Xeno Relations.
And it's part of Xenology, isn't it? Is it? No.
Yeah.
Oh, it is.
Yeah, Xeno Relations, the first thing...
Looking at the wrong one. Yeah, I need to unlock government, which I'm doing at the moment. So it's not giving... Oh, it's at the moment, because I've got no one focused on research, it would take me 65 turns.
Okay, well, then you might want to drop a couple... Well, but you haven't built any research centers yet.
Yeah, exactly. This is still building at the moment. So when that comes through, I'll get a more realistic value of how long it will take me to sort it out. So then obviously I'll put people onto research as needed sorted.
How long till you get government, the first one?
At the moment, it looks like it says unlocking in 12 turns, but obviously I've got no one on research, so it's got nothing. I'm getting no research whatsoever, so I'm going to have to swap people over.
Yeah, why don't you put a couple people on research so that you can unlock government? And once you unlock government, you'll have a research lab. So I would unlock government, then get a research lab, and then after that, the next thing you'll be able to go after on the tech tree is Xeno Relations. So I won't get it right now because obviously there's no room for me
to. It's going to take 6 turns for me now to get onto that section where I can start to get it.
Okay.
Okay, so you're going to explore that world, aren't you? So I don't even need to explore that world. The one in there, the little connecting one next to us. But then again, I need to know what it is as well so I can know if it's worth colonizing.
It's a medium swamp abundant, so it's a nice world, and you're not playing the soccer, you're playing the Barathi, right?
Yes, most certainly am, sir.
Then there's no strategic advantage for you. I was going to say, if you're Sakura, then you should take it and make it an Uber World upgrade. That's their, like, racial or whatever.
Oh, of course. Yeah, it makes sense, I suppose, yeah.
But we want to try to divide these worlds up evenly. Do you have another good system to colonize yet?
Well, this one's the one connecting right next to my home world. This is the only other one I've actually even got to explore yet.
Okay, then take this system.
Yeah.
Send your colony ship here.
Yeah, it is. It's on its way at the moment. It takes another 2 turns to get here, unfortunately. The Balrafi are very slow at transportation, unfortunately. The ships are very slow.
Well, everybody's ships are slow at the beginning.
Is it? Oh, I didn't know if it was difference between the races
in
the sense of travel times.
No, I don't remember any racial bias or trait that makes their ship slower. We're just all really slow as hell at the beginning.
All right, so now we've got that going on. I suppose, all right then. So what we'll do then, so are you going to take the... Yeah, so you've got Toranor?
That's my homeworld.
Your homeworld?
Yeah, that's my homeworld. So basically
right, so you've
what
got
you
Alatar
should do
in
is...
There, and then I'll get this one and...
Take this one, and then Ursa has multiple connections, you said, out of it, though, right?
Yeah, Ursa's got 3 warp points connecting off of it.
Okay,
at this
then
point
you
in time.
Need to rapidly go check everything that's connected to that, and then try to forward colonize on the other end. And like we were talking about in between episodes, the strategy is probably going to be, if it holds up, I'm going to go right next turn. Ooh. I'm going to go to...
Just to let you know...
Yeah.
I have just encountered another race. Guess who?
I don't know.
It's the Mercian Pride.
Really?
They are, yes. They are just coming through to this, it's called, I think it's Ryler. which is if you are where your ship is currently, if you went straight across west from there, that one right there, that yellow star, they're actually just heading into that sector now.
Okay.
So I'm assuming that their home world is literally just to the southwest of that. It's the blue star to the southwest. There is no direct connection point there.
Okay. Okay. I know what you're talking about.
Yep.
So what I was saying was is that we need to secure... Okay, so it might end up being that this system right here that you're going to colonize, that might be a point that we're going to need to secure quickly, and then we need to pick somewhere galactic north of Ursa. We need to find a point that we can strategically lock down. So you'll need to build a space factory and then build some military outposts and put some ships on it, but we need to lock it down. And then I'm going to take this system, Signy, that's got three planets in it, that's right next to the galactic core. It's that... what is this? It's a red star, right next to the galactic core.
Okay, yeah.
That's connected to Orion. So I'm going to take that system and secure it no matter what, even if it has crappy planets in it.
Okay.
Because we want to make sure, even though no one has the tech to take Orion now,
you don't want to make sure as it later.
Yeah, we don't ever want them taking it. So, and whether it's me or you, it's irrelevant in terms of who ultimately colonizes Orion. Basically. The important part is we want to deny it to our enemies.
Yes, of course. No, that sounds like a plan.
I'm good to go.
Yep, all right then, next turn it is. Not happy with being this close to their home world. It at least looks like there's either one or two connection points to their home world from this Ryler system, so, does not bode well.
Got a free frigate from an anomaly, that was nice.
Oh, did you go to the anomaly right next to it? Ah, see, that was the one I detected earlier.
And I just found a huge, arid, abundant world. Wow. Wow. Okay, well, that's awesome. Glad I took the time to actually check the planets in this system.
Yeah, I've got one in the Ryler 2. Is medium, Terran, rich in minerals.
You found a medium, Terran, rich?
Yeah.
Then... okay, then go colonize that first.
I've got I'm actually only two turns away from my second colony ship, so.
Oh, okay. Okay. So well, you need to get that. Like, that's.
Yeah, I think I'm going to head straight for that.
It's. How big is it?
It's only medium, unfortunately. Okay. But it is Terran and it is rich in minerals, so.
Oh, man, that's awesome because that means it's going to grow fast and you'll be able to build quick.
Yeah, that's it. So I think if I head straight for there afterwards.
That's sexy.
Okay.
Let's see. You know, the other thing that'll happen is once we have the Xeno relation stuff, and we can actually, the other thing we can do is we can actually trade space charts.
Oh, yes, of course. Yeah, I've done that in my single player. It's definitely well worth it, isn't it, at the end of the day, just to get full planetary information.
Let's see. I'm going to grab biology. You let me know when you start on Xeno relations so I can switch my research. All right.
All right,
I'm going into the next turn.
Same. Oh my goodness, they are moving in quick. There's now two of them here, and it looks like their scout might try to attack my scout, which would be stupid because I'm now going to reinforce it with a frigate.
Yeah, the scouts are unarmed, so they can't do anything.
All right, cool.
But a frigate will eat a scout for breakfast.
Yeah, I don't know if I want to start a war with them quite yet. I don't know what's... what's your opinion? You don't really want to start fighting them right now, do I?
No, I would say no. And what I'm going to do is I'm going to send, even though we don't have an official agreement, you know, so our ships can't fight together against an enemy.
Yeah.
We can still fight against an enemy. So I got this free frigate from that anomaly. I'm going to send it to your homeworld, and then I'm going to head to that system you're talking about to help secure it so that they don't come through.
Yeah.
And then I'm going to send my scout back home. So I'll send a frigate to you and I'll send my scout back home.
Okay, so this one I've just colonized then, this is it Tyas Prime?
Mm-hmm.
I've got one population on it, obviously, from the ship. So what do you reckon is the best thing to start off with? Should I just start him off rather than on production than on food, or what do you reckon?
What? Grab him and put him into production, and then tell me how many turns it will be to your next population.
At the moment, it says food zero, so it doesn't give me any amount of turns.
Oh, it's food. Okay, it's food zero. Okay.
So I suppose I could.
You have hydroponic farms yet?
No, unfortunately not, because obviously we'll focus my first bit of research on the government rather than that.
But you do have automated factories.
Yes. Yeah, so that will be pretty, yeah, so I could build that, I suppose. What do you reckon?
I would build that, and then as soon as that's done, I would move the guy to food.
Yeah, that seems like a plan.
That's what I would do. That way there's always some production going, and then you'll have a guy that's working on food.
Okay, nope, that sounds like a plan. I've got that sorted. Okay, my next colony ship will be reduced in one turn. So that's cool. Alrighty then. Alright, well, I think for now then, I don't know, maybe I should put my frigate guarding the warp point to my... Well, because they're only scouts, so I suppose it's not really an issue, is it?
You want to secure... Okay, so you always want to secure the furthest point that you can strategically hold. So I don't have visibility yet, so I don't see this other system, but I would, wherever those Martians, wherever they are, the cat people, if you can keep them from leaving that system that could allow them to come to Ursa, you want to secure it on that end, not on your end, if that makes sense to you.
Yeah, of course. Okay. All right then. Okay then. Yeah, then that
and I'm
going
to come meet you with my frigate and try to help protect.
Okay. Wee, and Ursa 2 has grown. I must stick out my claws on this matter. Okay. Nice. Okay, so we've got new production. So, what to build? Well, at the moment, I've got nothing really worth producing. Unless I want to build another sort of colony ship or something. So I'm thinking maybe I should put it all into research for now. All the guys from my production into research. On my homeworld, just to get that research out of the way as quick as possible. What do you reckon?
Are you at max pop already? No, right?
No. Next population's 8 turns, so...
Yeah, you always want to leave at least some people on food for growth.
Yeah, no, that's right. I've got 3 guys in there. I was thinking of moving the 2 guys I've got on production into research.
Probably, you already built an automated factory, right?
Yes, that's it. The only things I've got left to build are missile bases and ships.
So I would start construction, if it were me, I'd start construction on another colony ship, and yeah, I'd move those guys to research. That's a good call, because you need to make up the research gap a little bit so that we can get these agreements.
So, all right, what I'll do is then I'll start producing another colony ship. I'm going to have 1 guy on there on the production end and then 3 guys on the research, which means that now the government research will be completed in 2 turns, which is slightly better, which means I'm going to get there a little bit faster. Because they're basically only worth, as you said previously, 1 apiece, so it's going to take me a little while because they're just big and dumb.
That's okay, though. It's going to unlock research labs. So then what you're going to want to do is... put them back to production and build a research lab right away. And then when the research lab is done, you'll be getting, you know, an extra 2 points of research every turn. And then if you can afford to buy outright with just using credits, 1 on your other planet that you've colonized, then you'd be getting 4 research points a turn that you're essentially, other than a little maintenance on those structures, you're not spending any population for it. And that'll help.
Yeah, no, agreed. Okay, then it sounds like we're onto a winning plan here. Okay, so, all right then, I'm going to advance to the next turn. Oh, GNN.
GNN.
You are tuned to GNN, the only network that tells you what you need to know. Bringing it to you live.
Galactic News Network, the galaxy's most reputable news source.
Okay.
All right. Just the random...
Other than the ticker, they didn't even tell us anything. Okay,
yeah,
that's fine.
That's it.
Whatever.
I think the ticker's just random as well, isn't it? There's no actual value of information in there, or is there?
No, sometimes there is. Like, it'll tell you that such and such world, and it could be the other empires that you haven't even made contact with. They could say such and such world, their minerals increased, or they were attacked by pirates, and this happened. So you can pick up some things from it. The big announcements are the ones like such and such holds so many systems or such and such.
Yeah, that's the ones.
One.
Yeah, those are the ones. Yeah. That's normally a mainstay, though, isn't it, of the of that actual news report, so to speak. So it's actually something they comment on.
Yeah, exactly.
Okay. All right. Well, that's pretty much me done for this turn. So I'm just going to advance to the next turn.
Let's see.
So how's your building going in your area anyway? Is it all flowing as you'd like it to?
The Akari have a little bit different bonuses, but it's fine. Like I said, recently I've been playing the Sakura a lot, so they grow fast, which is kind of nice because they require less food.
They're
25% less food as a racial trait, which is pretty strong. And my guess is people, especially people new to the game, like you are, they might see that and go, well, that's not a big deal. And you wouldn't think it would be, but it's kind of substantial.
All right. Awesome.
Let's see. What research are you on right now?
I'm still on, obviously, just the first piece. So trying to get that the government system in place, basically.
Okay. I'm going to grab...
But it only take me...
That?
Maybe... I think maybe it'll be done next turn.
Okay.
Yeah, one turn. Sorry. I'm ignoring the very obvious bar at the top of my screen saying one turn.
All right, I'm going to grab fusion drives, which is not something I normally would grab this early to make my ships faster.
Yeah.
But since I feel like we're in a pretty good strategic
position yeah.
and us being able to move back and forth quickly is important, I'm going to go ahead and grab that.
Right, sounds good.
Let's see. Now I'm just trying to figure out where to send this colony ship. Large abundant. Yeah, so I've got a couple of decent planets right now, and I am sending this colony ship forward because I want to secure that system that I talked about that's basically galactic north of Orion.
Mm-hmm.
So that's probably where I'm going to make my foothold on my side to try to secure us, because if we can secure the two ends, they're not going to be able to do anything to us, really.
Yeah. Okay, well, I'm going to go for Xeno Relations then. Now, this is actually going to cost me 16 turns, believe it or not.
Going to be 16 turns?
Yes. So, I'm going to start that off.
Okay, I'm switching then to that.
And I'm now exploring the area above me. There's four planets in that one. It's not too bad.
That's nice.
And my colony ship is heading towards... Obviously, colonizing that Terran planet, so hopefully that will do me well. Okay, I think that's all I've got going on for now. I'm guarding the warp point access to where my homeworld is, so it doesn't look like they can get through to me for the time being.
Oh, okay.
Have you encountered someone, have you?
Yeah, Marshan Pride.
Oh. Oh, So how did they get around? Oh, they must have gone through the warp gate then.
No, that yellow star, they came, that's where their homeworld is, I guess. And they came through with a scout. Yeah.
No, because I think, well, as far as I'm aware, I think Firas, which is just west, is their homeworld.
It's the light blue. I see it.
Ah, so you're, so they've got, so they've got two connections coming out of their homeworld, one going round the edge of the system to you.
Yeah, there's no way in hell I'm letting them go. I'm not even going to let them scout past this system. So what I'm going to do with the frigate that I have in the system Ulthar is I'm going to guard this point.
Mm.
And that scout can go look at that orange star system if it wants. But I'm not letting it look at this system that's got the eel and stuff in it. Because, yeah, no way I'm letting them do that.
Yeah, sensible.
So we may have to build up and fight them sooner rather than later, because what's going to happen is they're going to feel boxed in and they're going to get aggressive. So
it's not looking too good in respects to their positioning. It's not good. Not good at all. Okay. Verily. All right. So the game's progressing quite quickly, actually, when it comes down to it. Alrighty. All right. Well, I'm going to go colonize that world anyway. So that'll be this turn.
Oh, look at you, fancy pants.
Okay, nice. That's good. I do like it. I see what you mean. The music does make all the difference to those little colonization sequences.
Yeah. But the little GNN report says that you're in the lead.
Oh, wow.
Your systems.
All right, see, it doesn't tell me that, you see. Okay, so
didn't get the GNN report?
No, because I was the one colonizing, so you guys got it, but I didn't.
Yeah, I got the little GNN report that was like, the Barathi Empire now controls three systems in its race to the top.
Okay. That's cool. So I think automated factory is most probably the most sensible starting point, isn't it? Do you reckon?
Yes.
For the new world,
Yeah, it is.
Rather than research.
And until you have hydroponic farms, and then what you would do is you would do hydroponic farm, then automated factory, then research.
I see. Oh, now it's given me the GNN just to say, like, hey, I control three planets. Oh, that's very helpful, but I knew that. Okay, so I've got a fleet that needs orders. Okay, there's nothing really interesting in this. They're all, there's barren, tundra, barren.
that doesn't mean they're necessarily bad. Their tundra is not that bad, and neither is barren. What are their mineral resources?
One of them's
and how big
rich,
are they?
And one's got artifacts. The medium one is rich and got artifacts, so that's not.
Okay, so
bad,
that's a
I
great.
Suppose.
That's a great world then.
Yeah, the other ones are none and low, pretty much, and poor on minerals and stuff like that. So that's not very good. One of them's got the small tundra. It's got abundant though.
That's probably not worth it right now. There's better worlds for you to get, but yeah, but that other one's good.
All right, so it's now going to take me 11 turns, just to let you know, to get Xeno relations.
Okay.
Okay. There's no way I can seal them off from coming out of this area. This is not good. Okay. Well, all right, then I suppose I'm going to advance the next turn. Because I've at the moment, why I suppose, because you've got people on your end now, so you kind of need your frigate as well, don't you? Because there's only two connection points, I believe, to that system, to their home world, which I could seal off one, and if you seal off the other, but then means sacrificing one of your ships basically to come protect me, and that's just not worth the hassle for you at the end of the day.
I wouldn't say that. I've already got this other end secured for now. Let's see. What are we going to do?
We've got abundant and gold on another one. That's not too bad.
Oh, extra income's always good.
Next population's 8 turns away, though.
See, so, like, as an example, that first colony, it finally got done with its automated factory. So I took the guy off of production, I threw him on food, I'm going to get next population in 2 turns, nice. And the research laboratory will be done in 14. So it's now it's kind of on its way type deal.
Yeah. Oh, it's all a little tense. I just don't like not knowing where
actually,
their ships are.
Oh, my God. I don't know. Hold on. Is that right? Yeah, no, okay. For a second there, I was freaking out. But I was like, wait a minute. Why is that only at 1 pop still? Like, no, it's fine. Freaked myself out. So I got a research lab on my main world almost done, and like I said, the other one will be done in 14 turns. That'll be good.
Yeah, nice. Awesome Doubt. Source. Okay, so one of my fleets needs orders, which is that guy that's... Alright, so I know this place over here connects to that warp point, so I suppose time to go over there.
Now remember, if you're trying to secure something with a scout, it won't secure anything.
No, of course, because it's not got any kind of defensive or offensive capabilities. I'm just trying to see how many connection points there are.
Oh, right. Yep. This is weird. I went to a yellow star system, no planets at all.
Oh yeah, I had one of those in my single player, which seemed overly odd.
It's very strange. Normally that's where you find like the really good planets.
Yeah. So obviously they've done something to the mechanics in this one to say that it doesn't always... It must be randomized, mustn't it? So it must be like, I don't know, maybe a 1 in 10 chance it will just be empty.
I guess, yeah. A little surprising though.
Yeah, wouldn't have expected it.
Okay, I got 5 turns left to Xeno relations.
Cool. I'm on 8 tens left at the moment.
Okay.
Okay. Right, I'm just going to advance my next turn straight off the mark because I'm literally not doing much at this point. It's all about waiting.
Same.
All right, one of the... I know they're called the Martian, but I want to call them the Persians just because of the cat. So the Persians are back.
Okay, so this... So if they're down there, you need to put... How many connections are in that yellow star system?
The Rylar one, the one that I'm on at the moment.
There's three
connections.
There's three connections there?
Yeah.
Which makes okay,
it,
so...
Well, it's four in total, including the one connection to my home world. So this is why it's kind of an awkward one, because it's going to be hard to almost impossible to seal that off in my current condition, basically.
All right, so I'll send that other frigate to that system, and I'll help you protect that system.
Okay.
And then I have... Currently have Dulls and Ulthar secured, kind of. I mean, they could easily destroy a frigate if they really wanted to, but they'd have to want to is basically the deal there, right?
Yeah, definitely. Okay, well, finally my automated factory is completed on my new planet, so we've got that. Okay. So, research laboratory and government support facility. I suppose it's going to be research, isn't it, really? Well, I don't know. He's got a swap to food, though, hasn't he? So, it's no point, really.
Well, once you're done with your automated factory, you should switch to... you don't have hydroponic farms yet, right?
No, that's it. So, I think I got to put on food. Next
then
population,
you put
though, 2 turns.
I would put them on food anyway, and then since you have the automated factory, have it start building a research lab.
Yes, good point, good point. Alrighty. I keep on forgetting about that bonus point for the production. I'm going to split the scout off and go see where these guys are going to, because I can't see that one of their scouts went off to one of the systems and he hasn't come back yet, so I'm assuming there must be another connection to it, and I'm wondering if that has a connection to the wormhole. If so, that's going to be aggravational, because that means there's a minimum of 2 connections to the wormhole at this point. Okay.
I'm going to move closer. Mm-hmm. Now I can see Rayla. And you're in there right now? You have a ship there now? Okay.
Yeah.
All right, so I'm going to head up there with a frigate. It looks like if we secure that system, we pretty much have them...
Pinned.
...strangled over there. Yeah, it doesn't appear to be any other way for them to come through. So I've got 2 frigates headed to that system now.
Okay, nice.
Threatening fleet detected? What, the space monster? No, that's not a threat. Silly space monsters. Well, this is interesting. I just discovered a system that's got 4 connections off of it. Okay. Well, that way then, I guess.
Okay, that's me done for this turn.
Okay, and since we know that that's going to be a problematic area, I am sending a space factory that way. It won't be there for 16 turns, but once it's there, I can build some military outposts, and that'll help us out a lot.
Hmm.
My Xeno relations is done. What do you
Mine's
got, like 2 turns?
4 turns, unfortunately.
4 turns. Okay, that's okay. Problem.
Same amount of turns to my next colony ship. So, doing not too bad. I say they're really good at producing sort of any kind of builds with this. This is the thing with the Bolrafi.
Well,
they seem to be very hardy.
It's a fast growing, fast expand race, and that's why I said it's one of the more aggressive ones.
Yeah. That was it. I found that with my single player. They were definitely conquering the universe first. I think they had 8 planets before I even had 4.
The risky part about massive expansion, obviously, though, is that if you get caught off guard, if somebody puts together a little fleet, they can come and like just crush your face. So you got to be careful. Yeah. Right now, we're in relatively good shape because even though the Martian Pride are
nearby, they, it's still early days, isn't it?
Yeah, and right now, if they start something, you know, that's going to be bad times for them. So
yeah, well, that's it. Unfortunately, because we're so close together, ooh. Oh, yeah, so that's you coming out from the south as well. Okay, yep. That's very cool. So there's two connection points to this one zone.
So if you want to move, what do you got there? A frigate? If you want to move your frigate to one of the other connections, go ahead and move. And then I'll come up behind you and secure these others.
Yep, no, that sounds like a plan. Cool, I shall do that. I have to wait till next turn at this point.
Just a second here. Why is it saying this? It doesn't need orders. Oh, maybe it did. All right. Sorry, game. Maybe you did need orders.
All right. So if I... Oh, my goodness. There is. There's two connection points to the wormhole.
Oh,
I was really hoping for one. And there is then four connection points from the system next to it, the one just north of this Ryler.
Got a random event that halved my research.
What was it? What was the event?
Corrupt like a virus in their computer systems.
Oh, what?
Mm-hmm.
Well, at this point, I'm going to point out that you chose to put random events on. No, I joke.
No, it's okay. It'll be all right.
Okay, so on this point, I'm going to start my research laboratory on my other new planet, and I am going to move my guy to food.
Uh-oh.
What's the uh-oh?
Why, just met the Sakura.
Oh no. Yep. Everyone's just popping in for visits nowadays, aren't they? Okay, so if that's there. Oh, this is not good. So there's connection points. So I need to basically establish a colony in Imra and Kita to secure the wormhole. That's the only way I'm going to manage this. Okay. All right then. Now I think I can get this wormhole guarded then. I think I can do it. It's just going to be two systems to lock it down.
I'll put one frigate on that warp point, and then as you move away, I'll secure the one that you're leaving.
Okay. All right, I'll advance to next turn then. Oh, I'm now getting an offer to trade. So
that you
when it comes up, accept? Well, this is the thing. It offers me to... Yeah, because obviously they're proposing it to me. But I don't understand, like, they haven't put a proposal on the table, so I don't know what I'm accepting. Oh, is it just pieces? Is that just the offer?
Could be. I mean, you don't have Xeno relations done, though, right?
Yeah, no, so...
Then you just escape out of it. They're saying they want to do something, but you don't have the tech to make a negotiation work.
So if I just go decline, that won't have any negative impact?
It shouldn't.
Okay.
And even if it does, who cares? Quite frankly, because we're going to end up destroying them anyway.
Yeah, exactly. Yeah, but there's no reason not to lure them into a false sense of security.
Oh, no. True. Okay, yeah. So the Sakura have two systems, which is surprising. I figured they'd have more, so that's good for us.
Okay. All right, so let's have a look. What's this other planet in this area? So we've got one planet in Imra, which is volcanic, abundant. It's large. Gold, but volcanic's not fun, is it?
And it's not so hot. I think there's some tech later that makes volcanic worlds, like, I guess, decent or whatever.
Yeah.
But we're going to have to end this one here,
dude. The other one's a large swamp and it's poor minerals, but it's got a gem as a special.
Well, might be worth it. But we got to end this one here because we're over on time.
Oh, we over on time. Oh, my apologies. See, I'm getting way too into it, as always, Mal. As always. Well then, ladies and gents, thanks so much for joining myself, IDED, and Mal for this continuation of our co-op Let's Play of course, Master of Orion. It has been so much fun. Self-evident from the fact that obviously I can't seem to draw myself away from the game, so I apologize again, Mal. But still, remember to click that thumbs up if you enjoyed it. Remember to watch it on both channels if you're watching on Mal's, or if you're watching it on mine. Just remember, just go over there and give them a like as well, because it's so well worth it. And of course, till next time, this will be IDED signing off, and see you soon, Mal.
You later. Thanks.